Hi there.
In this video, you're going to learn about layers. If you're coming from Illustrator or Photoshop, you should already have a pretty good idea what layers are and how the whole concept of layers work. However, I'm going to cover it anyway to shed any clouds there are about layers. Let's understand it using this image here. You can see a camera facing down and three layers titled on the right. If I add a rectangle on the first layer and the camera clicks a picture, it should be able to cover the entire rectangle that's lying on the first layer. Now let me add another rectangle on layer 2. Let's also shorten the rectangle in a way that the rectangle on layer 1 covers the entire rectangle on layer 2. When the camera takes a picture now, do you think the pink rectangle will be captured by the camera? Of course not, because it is completely hidden under the element of the first layer, which is a bigger rectangle. Now let's make another rectangle on layer 3 and enlarge its size. This time when the camera clicks a picture, do you think the rectangle on layer 3 will be there in the image? Yes, it will be there, but only the two sides that are extended beyond the sides of the rectangle on the first layer. So this is the basic concept of layers. If you understand this well, you'll never face difficulty with layers in InDesign or Photoshop or Illustrator as well. Now let's quickly put this concept to use and create a letter-sized document in InDesign. Let's drag the layers panel out. If you don't see the layers panel, go to Window and you should find it sitting under it. Or you can press the shortcut F7. At this point, you should be able to see just one layer on the layers panel. Double-click it and rename it Texture. Now click the small plus button at the bottom of the layers panel to add another layer. Now double-click this new layer and rename it Text. Similarly, make another layer and rename it Image. Actually, let's click and drag the text layer on top. Next, lock the image and texture layers by clicking the empty space right next to the eye icon, and you shall find a lock appearing next to each of the layers, which means now you should not be able to move any element or create any element within these two layers. With the text layer selected, grab the text tool and make a text box covering half of the page approximately. Right-click the text box and fill it with some placeholder text. Change the font to Roboto Black. Since the text looks too busy, let's divide it into two paragraphs and delete the rest of the text. Now select the entire text and increase the font size to 18 points. Alright, our task in the text layer is completed. Let's lock the text layer. And now you should know how to lock a layer. And then unlock the image layer. To unlock a layer, you just need to click the lock icon once and it shall be unlocked. So basically, it's a toggle switch. At this point, let's add some bleed to our document because we'll be extending the image from one corner to the other. So go to File and then Document Setup. Let me introduce another nice feature of InDesign. You could see that the unit of measurement is set to picas. But for some reason, I don't know picas. Or let's just say I'm not comfortable with this unit of measurement. But I know pretty well the measurements in millimeters. So what I'm going to do is enter 3mm, mm for millimeters, and take my cursor somewhere else on the panel. And you could see that InDesign does the calculation perfectly and enters the 3mm equivalent of picas into the bleed field. And this works for other units of measurement as well, so do make use of this amazing feature. Now I'm going to hit OK, and I should find the document surrounded by 3mm bleed. Let's grab the rectangle frame tool and make a rectangle covering the rest half of the page, and ensure to include the bleed space as well. Now go to File, and then Place, and locate the image from the computer and hit OK. So now we've got our text layer and the image layer ready. And at this point, none of the two layers so far is disturbing or hiding the other layer in any way. You can check the document in the preview mode as well. And for that, just hit the letter W and you should be able to see how the document will look once printed. Hit the W key again and it's going to be back to the normal editing mode. Now lock the image layer and unlock the texture layer. With the texture layer selected, grab the rectangle frame tool and make a rectangle from one corner to the other, covering the entire page, including the bleed. You should be able to see that we are able to view only half of the frame that we've just made because the image layer is right on top of the texture layer, and it's hiding the rest of the rectangle frame. You should be able to connect the dots now of what we discussed in the beginning of this lesson when I spoke about the camera capturing those images of different layers. Anyway, let's go to File and then Place and locate the image from your computer and hit Open. Now you see, since the texture layer is right at the bottom, even on the screen, it is behind the image and the text. Once I drag the texture layer on top, you'll find that since this layer covers the entire page, everything under it is now hidden. This is the right time to introduce another concept to you. So first of all, have your texture layer selected, and then right click and go to Effects, and then Transparency. In the pop-up menu, ensure that your preview option is checked, and let's change the blending mode to Overlay. What overlay blending mode does is that it multiplies or screens the color depending on the base color. Patterns or colors overlay the existing pixels while preserving the highlights and shadows of the base color. The base color is not replaced, but mixed with the blend color to reflect the lightness or darkness of the original color, which is why when you zoom in on this image, you'll find how brilliantly this image is fused with the texture layer, giving it a different look altogether. And all those layers can have sublayers as well. So if I click the small white arrow on the texture layer, you can find that this layer has just one sublayer underneath. If you keep on adding other elements to this layer, it will be stacked up here. Similarly, you'll find the sublayers of text and image layers. All these layers so far have just one sublayer because we did not add a lot of different elements to them. You can even select an element from this small square on the right. So suppose we want to move this image from image layer to the texture layer. So I'm going to click the square once to select it and then click, hold and drag it to the texture layer. The moment it is moved to the texture layer, it loses the special effect it had when it was the bottom layer, because by moving it, the entire algorithm changes. Now, when we click the texture layer, you shall find there are two sublayers. The one on top is the image sublayer that we just moved, and the other one is the texture layer, which was originally here. Let's undo the last action to put the image back to its place. So it's advisable to make optimal use of layers by placing objects on different layers and organizing them for easy selection and editing. Alright guys, that concludes our session today. I hope you've enjoyed it and have learned something new from it. So do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Until we meet again, goodbye and thanks for watching.